Hello again, and welcome to Mr. Mayor's Book Chats. Get right down to it. First book is Operatic by Kyle McClear, and this is a graphic novel. It's about a girl named Charlie who she has a class assignment for her music class to pick out the perfect song that exemplifies her. And while they learn about different types of music every single week, nothing is clicking for her. So she's worried about that. And then she's got some friend drama and a classmate that hasn't been to school in a few days that she's worried about. Not to mention, on top of everything, she's been talked into participating in an end-of-year performance with her best friends. But one day, their music teacher comes in, and this week they're talking about opera. And she discovers the music of Maria Callas. And the more she learns about Maria's life, the more Charlie admires her passion for singing and her ability to express herself fully through her music. So Charlie kind of finds some inspiration through Maria to kind of go through her own struggles in her life. So if you like graphic novels, check that one out. This is an older sports book, but one of my favorites. This is, I think, the first book that I read by Carl Duker, who's one of my favorite authors. It's about a high schooler named Shane. He's a closer for his high school baseball team. The pitcher whose job it is to come in at the end of the games when the pressure is mounting and to close out the game for his team. And baseball is Shane's world, and he's excellent at baseball. But his sophomore year is shaken when his father, who owns a car dealership, is arrested for money laundering at one of his games. And in a rapid spiral of events, Shane loses his father, his, you know, upscale home, his entire world is just shattered. And now suddenly they don't have any money. His mom and him have to find a place to live, kind of in this rundown apartment. And everybody looks at him differently because of what his father has done. So he has to kind of reshape his entire life and decide if baseball is worth still playing for him, if he still has that love. If you like gritty sports action, check that one out. Suspect Red is the next one. It's a historical novel. During the Cold War, when there were blacklists and political profiling and guilt by association, you know, if you were talking to the wrong person, you could be deemed suspicious. Well, this story takes place again in 1953. And when everybody is on edge, Senator Joseph McCarthy exposed people he deemed that were subversive and working with the communists. So everybody is looking twice at their neighbors, looking twice at anybody walking down the street, thinking maybe they're working against the United States government. Well, Richard, the main character, is the teenage son of an FBI agent living in Washington, D.C. And he belongs to a very important family. But when a family from Czechoslovakia moves in down the street, Richard finds out that the teenager in that family has a lot in common with him. You know, they share the same musical tastes, the same taste in books. But the Czechoslovakian family is very bold and does things that are different from people. And people start looking at that family a little bit suspiciously. And Richard has to decide, you know, what he can believe. And then finally, when Vlad's, the Czechoslovakian teenager's father, is questioned and comes under investigation, Richard is forced to confront kind of his beliefs about friendship and betrayal. Last book, Beverly Right Here. This is by Kate DiCamillo, who is just a fabulous storyteller. This is about a girl named Beverly, and she's run away from home plenty of times, but this time she's finally had enough, and she is going to do it for real. So she leaves, she finds a job and a place to live, and she, on her way, she meets all these interesting people, and my time is running out in this video. But if you just love great stories, check this one out. Also, Stories and Slices is coming up. If you've read Wild Bird or The Running Dream, come Skype with Wendelin von Dranen. As always, thank you very much.